thank you all for joining us today at Persian Art Exhibition. I'm very happy that I belong to a large family who I love and I'm enjoying my journey in Australia with. Thank you all for being here and for all your love and all your support. As some of you might know, SkyTrust is our software company, and we, with a diverse cloud-based organizational management system, which allows fully integrated business processes such as human resources, safety, quality, asset, and environmental management. And we've recently moved into this beautiful historic building with 40 years history in art, as a former art gallery, as many of you perhaps passed through or came in before. This February, I'm celebrating 4 years working with the SkyTrust and holding my second art exhibition in our innovative company. Special thanks to Corey Burford. He's not here today. I'll see him tomorrow with his family. The managing director of SkyTrust, who's supported my art from the very beginning. He's an intelligent and wise man who's open to wonderful adventures in our workplace. I thank him so much for the great opportunity. And thank you, SkyTrust team. Adrian is here, not all of them, for your support and help from and help with art exhibitions that I've already had and I'm having. I would like to thank my mum, who I exhausted a lot in her recent trip to Australia to make this wonderful event happen. She is returned to Iran now, and I'm missing her so much. She is the hearing of my life, and she's the one who introduced me to love, to the world of giving, to the world of less expectation. She introduced me to my spiritual path, to yoga and meditation, and that's how I met my gurus. I've always introduced myself as a self-taught artist, but that's not true. I've been learning all my life. I've learned patience from mum. I learned how to find space for things in my life that I value when I have multiple things to do. When I found my gurus, I learned stability, consistency, and dedication. I learned how to farm on a wheat field with a group of people dedicating love to the wheat in order to nourish people with love. That's where the idea of the wheat field comes from. In my spiritual path, I stayed behind a door for years. The door wasn't meant to open, despite my many attempts. Then suddenly, it opened up by itself. Open the door is from the time that I was behind it. When the tree of my life grew to the point that I decided to leave the motherland, the door opened and the tree started growing new, different types of leaves and being around new beds. In the beginning, I felt so lost. I couldn't locate myself in the new country. I felt empty. I felt nothing. I felt unstable and shaky. Then I realized that I've always been like that. I realized I've been always in the ocean of love, where you can't locate yourself, where you are always lost. but you're always protected at the same time. You're always loved. So there is no reason to fear. Let's live life as it is. When I rose from within, no one was there. I was alone in my art room, watching the beauty of the piece that I was doing. The beauty was not from the piece itself. It was not from me either. It was from someone beyond the piece and myself. It was being passed through the art. I saw the inner beauty that is usually hidden and beyond reach. The writings in my artwork are also hidden because sacred spiritual lessons are so subtle. In fact, they reveal differently depending on who's watching. My piece, Happiness, is from the thirst for happiness, the urge for it. Rumi says, everyone urges for something, and I urge for you. I say, I urge for the time I spend with my family, friends, and my gurus. We were practicing yoga meditation, farming, renovating our beautiful yoga school, and so many other things all together for years. That was my deepest happiness. I wish to dedicate happiness to my homeland. It's been done in memory of Shri Chinmoy, an Indian guru who dedicated all his life to inner peace and happiness. In his artworks, he used the spiritual symbols such as birds. The proceeds go to Nava Charity, which is a charity organization supported by Nava Yoga School in Tehran, Iran. As a member of Nava Yoga School, I'm so happy that I can contribute to establishing love between people outside of my homeland to people back in Iran. I wish good blessings for both groups, the people who will receive the piece and those to whom the proceeds will go to. And finally, currently I'm working on new artworks and I can't wait to introduce you to another level of adventure in my next main art exhibition. I wish you all love and joy. And thank you so much to be here today.